Everybody, that was Joe Bonamassa doing a cover of New Day Yesterday by Jethro Tull, who originally did the song way back in 1969. I think it was their first or second album called The Stand or The Stand or something like that. Or maybe I'm thinking of Stephen King, The Stand, the book. Anyways, it's an easy song to play. It's all compartmentalized into a bunch of phrases. And I guess the best thing to do is just get started and show you. So the initial thing I want to start off with is that signature phrase that he's doing. That's this. And what he's doing there is he's starting off at G sharp and climbing up G sharp, A sharp on the E string. Then he's going to the A string, and he's starting off on C sharp, D, and D sharp. So you got. Okay? And when he's on this D sharp note here, he's going to hit that a couple times and then do a pull off back to the C sharp and then land on the A sharp and finish on the D string on the F sharp, okay? All right, so all together it's. Okay? All right, and so the reason I wanted to show you that first, because the intro, he does the intro, and then he spills right into that phrase there. So the intro is F sharp, G sharp, B, and then E sharp, okay? So it starts off like this. So when he's coming off of this F sharp to G sharp, and he just rolls right into that phrase, okay? Okay, and when the vocals start, the vocals are on this. He plays this run here, which is the E sharp on the A string. Then he goes on the E string here, he goes B, B flat, A flat, okay? Back to the B flat, and then up to the F sharp again on the D string here. So let me go slowly with it and play the whole thing so you understand. He does that four times, and then he finishes it off by going to the A flat or G sharp here on the E string, to the E sharp, to B, back to the E sharp again, and I just throw in a slide down to the F sharp here to finish it off with the G sharp, B, F sharp, G sharp, okay? So that's that part. What else can I show you? Oh, when he comes out of the you know, just that real fast part here, this what he does there is he comes out of the that's the opening phrase of and he holds the B, then you hear the drums coming with a bum bum bum. Now I think he plays that like six times, and after he does it the sixth time, the seventh time, he actually just does a climb from G sharp, A to A sharp over and over. And he holds the A sharp and then stops. Actually, he doesn't hold it. I think he just stops. Go. Yeah, that's right. He just stops there. And then he pauses and then comes in with the E sharp. And I just play the octave. Okay? One other thing I can show you is when he's coming out of the vocal part here, and it's a it comes back to this E here. It sounds like it a slide is a slide or a hammer on or something like that is happening right there. It just fits. So I try to do this sometimes. So, did you see the sliding there at that one part? Yeah, you do what you want. But this is a fun song to play, and it'd be great if you get your bandmates together and they can, the guitarist and the bassist can play that together. It's got to be kind of cool. This is my, it's my interpretation of the song. If you have a better understanding of the song, please share it with me in the comments below. I would love to hear it. There's always somebody who can do something better, and I'm very open to learning the right way to do things. So don't be shy. Let me know what your thoughts are. If you have a comment or anything, let me know. Okay? I look forward to talking to you next time. Have a great day. Bye.